Okay, so after the first part, okay, we'll continue with the same. So by getting these properties, okay, so even I have mentioned in this small diagram, so you can refer, that is EXX and CXX. So from the center, from the centroid towards the junction, it is CXX about the horizontal axis, and from the center towards toe, it is EXX about the horizontal axis. And then if you consider the same about vertical axis, so it is CYY and EYY. So we have the angle is 80/50. So 80 mm is connected to gusset plate. So we have the properties like CXX and EXX is 27.3. That is CXX is 27.3 mm, EXX is 52.7 mm. That is nothing but H1 and H2. And if you add both the values, you should get 80 mm. Then only whatever values you have taken from the steel table, those values will be correct. Otherwise, if you add and if you could not get the length of the weld, the leg length, then it is wrong. So you have to, while selecting these values, you have to take care whether it will be horizontal, about horizontal or about vertical axis. So if it is about horizontal, it is always CXX and EXX. If it is vertical axis, it is always CYY and EYY. So we'll further move ahead. So they asked to find out the design strength of the member. So we can easily find out the design strength of the member as per clause number 6.2, page number 32. That is from IS 800. If you go to IS 800, clause number 6.2, page number 32, we can easily find out the design strength of the member based on yielding of the section due to gross yielding. So which is nothing but TDG. So TDG is what? AG into FY upon gamma m naught. So what is AG? AG is the gross area of the section, which is, you can get it from steel table. So in the table it is given that area of the section. Okay, so that is 978 mm. So 978 into FY is 250 divided by 1.1. so you'll get TDG, that is design strength of the member, means this much force can carried by the member, that is total is how much? 222.27 kilonewton. So therefore we can have the design load along LW1 and LW2. So total force is 222.27 that will be carried by the member. So automatically, according to that, we can find out P1 and P2. So further, before this lecture, I have told you how to calculate P1 and P2. So I have the equation here, that is P into H2 upon H, and for P2, P into H1 upon H. So based on that, we can calculate P1 and P2. And P1 and P2 are nothing but what? The force carried by LW and LW2. Means whatever the force P1 and P2, it has to be carried by length LW1 and LW2. Both are longitudinal fillet weld. Okay. So to know, to have that, we should have, from where we have got the values of H1 and H2. So H1 is nothing but CXX, where we can get it from steel table. And H2 is nothing but EXX, that is 52.7. So what is total height? H is equal to H1 plus H2, that is nothing but 80 mm. And these properties or the data we can get easily from steel table for ISA 80/50/8, unequal angle 80/50/8. If you go back and if you check, you will get the data very easily. Okay. Now let's move on to design of weld. Now in design of weld, what is the first? We have to find out what is the size of weld required. So I told you there are two categories in again, that is S minimum and S maximum. So what is S minimum? Again, you will get from that table number 21. Okay, if you go to IS 800, that is table number 21, page number 78, you will get S minimum. And S maximum, it is what? Thickness of thinner part minus 1.5. So here there are two elements, that is one plate and one is angle. So plate thickness is 12 and the angle thickness is 8. So thinner is 8 mm, so 8 minus 1.5, so is 6.5. So we have to choose between 5 and 6.5. so let us assume the size of weld is equal to 6 mm. So automatically what will happen? T is nothing but effective throat thickness is equal to K into S. So that is 0.7 into 6. So what will be T is equal to 4.2. okay, now we have to find out the design strength of weld. As if you get the size of weld, we have to find out the design strength of weld, which is given by FWD is equal to FU/√3 into AW upon gamma MW. So here they are given for site weld, so that's why it, gamma MW, you have to take it as 1.5. so therefore if you substitute back, FU is 410/√3 into AW is LW into TE. LW is unknown here, so we have to find out what is the length of weld required. Then T is 4.2 divided by 1.5. So from this you will get the design strength of weld, that is 662.79 LW Newton per mm. Okay, now we have to equate this to your strength of the member, which is offered by LW1 and LW2. So after equating the design strength of weld to the force offered by LW1 and LW2, we get P1 is equal to FWD. So from that P1 is equal to FWD, so therefore you will get LW1. So we required LW1 is equal to 225.87. So we will equate it to 226 or 230 mm. So again, if you equate it to P2 is equal to FWD, so you will get LW2 is equal to 114.42. So we will take it as 115 mm. Okay. So from this, what you can understood? So whatever the force carried by the section, that has to be transferred to the another section or the plate through weld. So whatever the weld is required, that should be based on P1 and P2. Because ultimately, whatever the design strength of weld, we have to equate to P1 and P2. P1 and P2 are nothing but what? The force offered by length of weld LW1 and LW2. So from the sketch, you can see that we have got LW1 is equal to 226 and LW2 is equal to 115. So we can say that LW1 is more than LW2. The reason behind this is, even I have discussed in the class, why the length of weld LW1 is more than LW2. Okay, it was a discussion in the class. So I told you that because there is a junction, okay, so junction is very near to CG. So automatically what happened, the force, whatever the force offered or the carried by the section, that has to be transferred more to the junction, and the whatever the remaining force, it has to transfer to the toe or the end of the section. Suppose there is a force 100%, so in 100%, the 70% of the force will be carried by the junction, and the 40 or 30% has to be transferred to the end. So that's why you'll get the length of the weld LW1 more than LW2. So this is the end of the problem. Okay, so after this you have to go through the solution, you solve it, and you find the properties from the steel table. If you get any doubt, if you get any queries, you can ask me on my personal contact number, or you can WhatsApp me. Okay, we can have the discussion for that. Okay, so in the next lecture I can explain those doubts to the all the students. Suppose if you get any doubt, okay, you have to contact me. Okay, and you have to go through the clauses, and you have to refer the properties for equal angle, unequal angle. Okay, in that you have to understand how to refer the properties, that what I told you, CXX, EXX, CYY, EYY. In that, if you have any doubt, please ask. Okay, if you have any problem, any doubt, you can contact me on my personal contact number or WhatsApp number. Okay, goodbye students.